The NDC flag bearer outlined how his next government will achieve this promise by injecting some $10 billion into the economy and by optimizing gaps in human resource in the public service.
We're going to inject money into infrastructural development again, because that will involve the construction industry, engineering, and so on and so forth. And so it will bring a lot of artisans and everybody back into work. We're looking at what I call the big push, the big infrastructural push. And that's going to be an injection of about $10 billion to dualize our roads, to complete the 200 senior secondary schools, to finish all the hospitals that we were building, you know, to do bridges, you know, in order to open up the country and all that. So there's going to be an injection of $10 billion. And we believe that that should allow the engineering sector and the construction sector, you know, the cement sector, you know, building material sector, you know, to create at least, you know, 300 to 400,000 jobs.
Mr. Mahama further promised that the next NDC government under his watch will see the construction of a public university in each of the six newly created regions in the country.
I'd already done a visit of the six new regions, and during that period I said an institution of higher learning that is basically a university will be established in the six regions. It will either be one university that has campuses in all the six regions, or it will be a number of different public, you know, institutions, because we want to take tertiary learning to every region. And it was the policy of Professor Mills that every region of this country must have a public university, and so that is still our policy.
The presidential candidate of the NDC in the interview took a swipe at the Akufo-Addo administration for what he says is the politicization of the judiciary.
There are some things that this government does that are tangible. I mean, in terms of setting us back and destroying our progress. But there are some things that are intangible, and the effects are not immediate to be seen. And that's why I said the tragedy is not in the huge debt. It is not in the huge ballooning fiscal deficit, but it is in setting back the institutions of democracy that we have built over the years. And I mean, you yourselves can see, I mean, the judiciary now has been packed with judges selected by this president. And so people, I mean, if you speak to anybody, they don't believe that you can get justice, you know, from this judiciary.
Meanwhile, the governing New Patriotic Party has urged Ghanaians not to take Mr. Mahama seriously.
The Constitution of Ghana states clearly as to the mandate of who has the right to appoint or to make such appointment. And let me assure you that in all cases, it is a recommendation. The president doesn't appoint. Even if the president wants to appoint his own brother, he will refer it to the Judicial Council. That is the truth of the matter. For the former president to say that the current president is politicizing the judiciary, it's unfortunate, it's unacceptable. The presence of Mahama once upon a time in the history of this country as the president sent us back. So he stopped making these comments. It is easier said than done. He has once occupied the seat of the president. Why didn't he deliver? He had every opportunity. He was a vice president and later he became a president. It is that Ghanaians are some kindergarten people that then he sits down there and then he rattles and he thinks that people will take him serious. The man has not learned his lessons. For me, honestly, he's not a serious politician. Government is not like using a test tube to perform experiments. It's a serious business meant for serious-minded characters.